Okay, so the first question is, what was your enlisting experience like?
Well, when I first enlisted, it was pretty weird because I was 24. And when I went to basic in school, I was probably, you know, 4 or 5 years older than everybody else. Mm-hmm. So in trying to get them to work with, you know, what they wanted you to do without thinking you knew more than they did, it was kind of hard, but, you know, it was a good experience, and, you know, I'm glad I had done it, you know, even though I was a little bit older, but I was glad that I went through it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, what field or area did you volunteer for?
When I enlisted, you go through a testing period, and they figure out kind of what areas you'll fit in, and mine wound up kind of in electronics area with communications, so that's where I started out. I was in communications whole time I was in service.
Okay, so you didn't change at all?
Nope.
What was your basic training like, and like what was your like daily routine?
Our daily routine would be we got up 4:30 in the morning or so. You'd go out and go in formation. We'd have our PT, our physical training, go for our run, come back, have breakfast, and then you spent the rest of the morning or day doing different tasks or things you needed to learn to get through basic training. And, you know, lunch, back to training, dinner, a little bit more training, and then just kind of doing cleanup or something. And that was pretty much day after day for, you know, 3 months.
So then you went down to, is that Texas down there?
That was in Fort Gordon, Georgia. And then after that, I went to Fort Jackson was in Georgia, and then I went to Fort Gordon. And then there you went to school, and that was a little more relaxed. You know, you still got up early, did PT, went to your classes, you know, and then in the afternoon you kind of were able to do your own thing. And as long as you checked in and checked out, you can go off base, go into town, whatever. So it was a little bit more of a normal life, but still had the rules to follow.
Okay. What did you do during the war, and like what were your assignments and duties every day?
I was a section sergeant, which I had 6 people that worked for me. Mm-hmm. And so I was in charge of you know, day-to-day task, what to do, what, you know, what their jobs were. When we first got into Iraq, we set up our communications shelters, and we supported a brigadier general for their backup communications. So it was pretty much a day-to-day, like work. You know, we got up and did our own little PT thing. We'd go over to the site and make sure everything was up and running. And then just kind of had different shifts because we ran 24 hours. And we were the backup or a redundant system because they had gotten a lot of fiber optics out there for certain things, certain other communications. But what we had to do was make sure that ours stayed up running in case something happened to theirs. And on a couple of occasions, there was some pretty big things going on, and their main system went down, and so they were going through us. We didn't even know it was happening. It was just a seamless transition from their main system over to ours. And you know, there was a whole lot of traffic going on, but we didn't know exactly what was going on until kind of after it happened, and they came in and talked to us.
So you never really ran into any big problems?
On our site, we didn't have any real big issues with our communications. We did have a couple near misses with some rockets and mortars coming in and hitting us close to our site. But we wound up, you know, nobody got hurt or anything from our group or our little location on the base.
Did you make any really close bonds within like the ranks of your soldiers and officers?
You do. And I think in different situations, those bonds are different. For us in the communications, we've all kind of kept in touch through Facebook and stuff like this now. You know, some people have been together a lot longer than others. One of the guys on my team wound up marrying my cousin, but they had gone to school together over in Woodbury and kind of worked at the same place. So it was just kind of funny that they knew each other and they wound up getting married. But you kind of make some close bonds. I think when you're in infantry and artillery and a few other of those things, when those guys are going out every day and actually, doing searches and stuff like this, those bonds get to be a lot closer because you're watching each other's back really close because you never know when something's going to happen. So some bonds are probably closer than others depending on, what your situation was.
So you still, keep in touch with them today?
Yeah. Later on in August, we're having a get-together for kind of an anniversary picnic kind of thing, and whoever makes it. So a lot of it is just still, on Facebook, seeing who's doing what, seeing some of these kids, that were, 19, 20, now are, have kids of their own and are growing up and the things that they're doing. So it's been kind of cool watching those people grow up. And some of them you didn't figure would stay in or wanted to get out as soon as they got done. They're 20-year people now. So, it's been nice to see that change.
Was it hard for you to leave your family? Like, how often were you able to communicate with them? And in what ways? Like, were you allowed to Skype them or did you write letters?
Yeah, we were fortunate because we're in a communications unit. We had a couple of guys that were IT techs.
Oh, wow.
One worked out at the U and one worked over at Dakota County. So when we were down, down in Texas, we set up a internet, a guy ran, a cable company. And so, I was able to, FaceTime, or now it's FaceTime, whatever they call it. But Skype or just video with everybody. And then when we got over in country, one of the guys found an outfit that had a satellite internet.
Oh, wow.
So everybody pitched in a bunch of money. We got a couple of satellite dishes. He set it up. Ran internet to everybody's trailer.
Oh, wow.
And I could talk with the computer and see everybody and talk to them. Almost every night, at least 4 or 5 times a week.
Oh, good.
They got to a point where the kids just, Dad's on the computer, and hi, Dad. it got to be a routine. To be kind of normal that way.
Okay, good.
And so, we were able to do that.
Oh, good. What were your views on, the Iraq Freedom at the time?
At the time, I thought we were doing what needed to be done, but the most part, the biggest thing was is, I was there because it was my job. I joined the service to do just what I was doing, and now I was actually doing what I was trained to do. I believed in what we were doing, and so we did what we were supposed to do.
What were your views on your individual role in the war? Did you think that you did enough or not enough?
Well, when you join, you think, okay, I'm joining the Army, I'm joining the Marines, whatever. You want to do what what the main job is. Everybody thinks, you're in the Army, that you're out there, looking for people, shooting, being shot at, whatever. But there are so many different aspects of being in the service, because you have those guys that are out there, doing that, doing patrols and everything. But behind them, you know, you have the administrators, you have your support units, and I felt we, you know, did an excellent job in what we did as far as their communications, because when we were over there, when we got our system up, we had an uptime of 98%. So that was like only 2% where the system was down in a significant amount of time, which is unheard of having that much uptime when a unit is deployed. So we were doing stuff that, you know, people just couldn't believe was happening. And the ingenuity between some of our specialists, some of our warrant officers, configuring things to make things work, which is outside the box of what the regular Army thinks about doing. That's why, you know, our IT guys have different experiences, life experiences, and things, you know, instead of just being regular, you know, Army, when this is our lane, and this is what we do, and this is how we do it.